Hi, Craig James with a wrap of the overnight action on Thursday. Well, the global share market correction has continued. If we look at the Asian trade of yesterday, Japan and Korea's markets were off in the order of 2%. That wrapped around to Europe last night, where European market more broadly was down by 0.5%, and the UK market down 0.8%. The German market down by 1.1%. And then we turn our attention to the US market, and the Dow Jones was down 252 points or 0.8%. 1.2% fall in the S&P 500, the broader measure of the US market, and also a 1.8% fall in the tech heavy NASDAQ. Certainly the selling seemed to be concentrated in terms of those technology stocks. Only three out of the 11 industry sectors in the United States managed gains, real estate, utilities, and also in terms of materials. Really, it was the outlook statements from companies that really put the pressure on share prices overnight. Meta Shares, the owner of Facebook, Q3 results were in line with forecasts, but they warned on the fourth quarter sales and the share price was down by 3.7%. A United Parcel Service, UPS, down 5.9%, lowering its full year revenue forecast. Hasbro, the maker of the Transformers action figures, it trimmed its revenue forecast and it was down by 11.7%. And Mattel shares down in the order of 7.6%. The Barbie doll maker warned of slower demand ahead. When you look at some of the other mega caps overnight, Amazon was down 1.5% in normal trade, up by 0.2% in after hours trade. Apple down in the order of 2.5%, and Microsoft in the order of 3.75% lower. So certainly we saw the continued weakness in the share market, but what we saw in terms of the economic data was the strength of or the resilience of the US economy. US economic growth, GDP, in the third quarter, 4.9% annualized, well above market forecast and the best growth figures in the order of 2 years. Inflation under control as well. The core measure of personal consumption expenditure deflator, the main measure of inflation basically in the economic release, 2.4% annual. So that's getting close to where the Federal Reserve wants it, around about 2%. A measure of business investment, durable good orders, up in the order of 4.7%. And the job market did soften overnight, which again, is measures as somewhat of a Goldilocks situation for the United States. Where it's getting some good outcomes coming through. The jobless claims up from 200,000 to 210,000. That wasn't far off the market expectation. So a bit of softening in terms of the job market, the broader economy doing sort of very, very well. What we saw in the bond market is a reaction to effectively those benign economic growth figures, good growth and contained inflation. US 10-year yields down 11 basis points to 4.84%, and US 2-year yields down the order of 8 basis points to 5.04%. Turning our attention to commodities, base metal prices were generally lower overnight, anything between 0.6% to 1.8%. We saw the biggest decline there in terms of zinc. The oil price continued to soften, suggestions that perhaps we may not see a widening of the conflict in the Middle East. The NYMEX price down by $2.18 to $83.21 a barrel. That's a fall of 2.6%. Good news for the gold bugs here in Australia. The gold price continues to rise, up in the order of $2.50 to $1,997.40 an ounce. So a soft Aussie dollar, a good US dollar price for gold. And that means gold returns for Australian producers is likely to be very well supported. When we look at our market today, we've got the producer price index or measure of business inflation, which is coming out. We've got annual general meetings from the likes of Steadfast, Carsales, SkyCity, Fletcher Building. We've got some production reports as well from Coronado Global Resources and Karoon Energy. And this is very timely figures. It's basically at the moment data on the economy or readings on the economy, and probably better than some of the lag measures that we get in terms of the economic data. In terms of our market today, the share price index on the futures exchange pointing to just a 3-point fall at the start of trade. And the Aussie dollar, well, it rose overnight against a weaker greenback. It's lifted from 62.7 cents, which basically was a 12-month low, up to 63.2 cents. So a fair bit to digest in terms of what's happening yesterday in terms of overseas. I suppose we should also preview what's happening in the United States later tonight. The personal income and spending figures, which has the preferred measure of inflation contained in it from the Federal Reserve, the private consumption expenditure deflator, that's coming out later this evening in terms of the United States. And their consumer confidence figures, which have a measure of inflationary expectations. So that's always worthwhile, you know, sort of looking at yesterday as well. So a fair bit, you know, sort of happening in terms of the economy, as is always the case. But on that note, I hope you have a very good day.